Hi everyone, Mary D'Alby here from Fitness Alliance International and welcome to Gimme 10, where we help you transform your body and your life 10 at a time. So here we are, just past halfway in the workout 10s. We're not in the gym as you can see. We are going to be working on a part of the core today, the core consisting of the abdominals, several back muscles, the diaphragm and the pelvic floor. We're actually going to be working on the abs today. So working on the upper abs, part of the six pack. And what the abs do is basically flex the body forward. So that's all we're going to be doing. It's a gym favorite. We're just going to be doing some crunches and adding a couple of variations to that. So first of all, some disclaimers. If you've got knee issues, we are getting down on the floor. So as you can see, take care getting down on the floor. If you have blood pressure issues, take care getting down and up off the floor. And if you have back issues, even though we're working the abs, it is going to have a big effect on your back. So stabilizing that and making sure everything is balanced between your front and your back is really important. So let's lie down, shall we? And get started. So starting in the traditional way, we're working on the upper abs for the most part, which is kind of above the umbilicus or belly button and below the ribs. So walking around the gym, you'll see people doing different variations of this exercise. One of my favorites is what I call neck ups, where they'll lift their neck up and they'll think they're actually working their abdominals. They're not. They get really sore shoulders, they'll have a really sore neck, and they may even start cramping up around the shoulders later in the day. And then there's the swingers, the guys and gals, who use their arms for momentum. Yes, they're sort of using their abs, but they're using their arms a lot more. When they lift themselves up by pulling their arms forward. What we're going to do today is activate the abdominals. To activate the abdominals, we're not going to be using as many other muscle groups just because it's an abdominal exercise. So first, what we're going to do, feet just below your butt and about hip width apart, nice and even. We're going to place our hands on our thighs. Now you may notice doing it this way, you're not going to get as many out as you would if you were using your arms, but you'll definitely feel it a lot more around the core and particularly in the upper abs. So hands on the thighs and just rolling up to the knees, fingertips to the knees, and back down again. If that's a bit too easy for you, we're just going to graduate from there. Go to the palms. So palms to the knees. I think that's my limit. But as you get more advanced, once again, go to your elbows. And if you can, get your chest right up to your thighs. So I think I'm actually crunching uphill here too, just to make myself look better. So rolling up. And remembering to breathe throughout. So breathe in as you come down and out as you crunch. So it's like you're squeezing the bellows to increase the flame on the fire. So you're squeezing them out and then inhaling and then squeezing to lift again. And also remember, the slower you go, the stronger you get. So if you can actually take 2 seconds to get up, hold for a second, and then lower back down for 2 or 3 or 5, that's going to have a better effect on your strength and even the conditioning of your abdominals. So in that, you can advance further by lifting the knees. Let me try that one. This one actually makes it easier, but it also activates the lower abs and also dropping to either side to work the oblique muscles. So we're actually going to do that in another Gimme 10. So we'll leave that for next time. And this is me, Mary D'Alby from Fitness Alliance International. This is Gimme 10, and we'll see you next time.